Carr, and who's in the goal square? Forbes, is it, or is Maybe. It Murphy?
Start of the final term. 12-8-80 planning, 9-9-63. Lovell and Hybens. Muir through the middle, gets the first possession, gets it to Nelson, goes up towards centre wing, Cornish in front, no mark taken. To Doro, runs away though, gets a Shepherd and goes with a right foot kick towards half forward. Hutchison comes across. Quinn Libben was there first, so he's going to run into his teammate. He runs on. It's run on at all costs, I suspect. Nelson now through the middle. He chips the footy towards Trotter. Takes the mark under pressure and runs away. Does well. Goes with the right foot kick long. Great kick two to Carr, and he takes the mark. They go up. A big pack's there. Werribee's got a couple in front. At the front of the pack was Forbes. Ripped off the football. The umpire says held to him, and it will be a ball up 10 metres out from the Imbolay goal.
Higgledon out of the goal square.
Higgledon out of the goal square. Interesting. That's good. Like that. Don't mind that. Ball up. Big thump away by Lovell. Great two to David Hall. Hits him on the chest and he runs free at half back. Ed runs through a couple. Goes through centre half back. Handballs it away to Knight. Gives it back to Hall. Gets it over the top to Dodoro. So Werribee are doing exactly what Inverleigh need to do. They're running the football. He goes to Chug. Under pressure from Nelson. Coming through Bremner. Fighting hard for it. Hall has to get back on it. He's got a couple in support as well. Knight's one of them. He handballs it over the top to the umpire and also Calbert. Calbert picks it up. Kick it around the corner towards half forward. Rosenwig got hold on to. Didn't matter. Should have taken the mark. Didn't in the end. Chug waits for Montgomery. Montgomery spins around. Gets the ball away to Chug under pressure. That's he ball. Dropped the football. That's holding it. Now Cornish comes at it. Pushed off the footy by Ling. He's over the top of it. He hatches it as well. Over the top Hutchison. Oh, he dragged it in. Cornish. The umpire will come in and ball up. And it will be a ball up. 40 by 17 points. And it'll be a ball up. Hybens. Calbert tried to kick it out of the middle of the air. Hutchison got it away by hand. Muir runs from half back. Goes long towards centre wing. Coming at it, Ansell goes up, gets a hand to it, doesn't take the mark. His second effort was pretty good. He got one eye too, and we'll get the free kick. So the big fella moving on at all costs by the looks of it. Oh, he's running around a long way now. The umpire calls it. Now goes up towards Hickledon, comes out in front though, taking the mark. Braden Smith does well. And we'll settle things down for Werribee. They lead 12-8-80, Inverleigh 9-9-63.
He goes short and finds Lovell. So Lovell still on the defensive side of the centre. Goes in short again. Calbert leads up. So now on true centre wing. Simon Calbert has the mark. Longer options further afield. It's going to be Montgomery. That's the direction he goes in. Also Chugs there. Both of them. Could be brothers, those two. They look very similar the way they move and act. But it's Muir who picks the ball up. Releases the ball over the top. Hybens has time to steady and has David Peel. Good views in. And he puts the ball out towards David Peel. Now he's in a paddock. Can pick the ball up and carry this a long way if he wants to. Has one bounce, two bounce. On centre wing. Decides to load up and go long. In towards Ansell behind. Hall gets the ball to the ground. Good clean pick up from Lockie Hill at the back of the contest. Goes into the pocket. And he finds Carr. So Matthew Carr in the forward pocket has Hickledon out from centre half forward, and that's the direction he goes in, and the mark has been taken. So good clean movement from Inverleigh. We'll give them an opportunity here. Zach Hickledon, 25 metres out, almost directly in front, can go back and give Inverleigh some chance here with the first goal of the final quarter. So Hickledon comes in now, direct approach. Nice looking kick off the boot, and Zach Hickledon has his first goal of the afternoon. Sorry, not only has his second, and now the 10th to Inverleigh.
In the middle, Lovell pushes Hybens off the ball. Bray taps it on to Knight, gets a clearing kick to half forward. Coming across, Quinn Liven can't take the mark. McHenry oh, knocked off the football by Calbert. Ling backs himself to come out. Calbert now, if he can pick it up, he might be in. He can't, and he drops the footy, does he? The umpire says play on. Hutchison doesn't keep his feet. Now he gets up again, handballs it away to Quinn Liven. He takes the bounce, runs outside defensive 50, handballs it to Trotter, handballs it back to Quinn Liven. He gets around two. And goes through Knight, goes with a kick towards Ansell on centre wing. He runs around, goes with a right foot kick long towards half forward, sits it up. Carr runs back, doesn't take the mark, needs some support. Through the middle, Braden Smith tried to get rid of the handball, under pressure, umpire said, and dropped the footy. I think she pulled the punts out there.
Wasn't very punchy.
No, she needs a bit of work on the punts, doesn't she?
I want to see her get low.
Get those hands through.
So I used to always just do a little one and then just run.
Come on, Cal. That's why you're not umpire anymore. You need to get theatrical about it. They practice it, you know. I've seen them at Kinnear Park. Practice it. It's hilarious.
I never went to training.
Oh, surprise, surprise. So, 50 out from goal. Matthew Carr. Left foot kick. Hasn't got the distance. Off hands. Through 4-1 behind to Inverleigh. They go to 10-10-70. They trail Werribee Central's 12-8-80. It's on the Smith Holden Blood Suzuki final quarter scoreboard. 6 minutes played.
David Leach will do the kicking in, and the game plays onto himself in that full-back position. Runs his full quota, then decides to go out long. Ellis comes across, good mark, reaches up, good stretch. So Devin Ellis now with the ball. Bell further afield. Chug's going to wear where he goes to, and it's a nice look, well-balanced kick and a good weighted kick. Unfortunately, Brendan Chug,
nice. Yes.
So Brendan Chug, the recipient of the free kick on centre wing, goes short and over the top. Calvert comes up, leads and takes the mark. He's been good today, Simon Calvert, but I don't think he gets enough ball inside 50 to be dangerous. Goes towards Rosenweg. That's the bloke that's been dangerous today. Montgomery, Rosenweg emerges with the ball, swings around, goes back towards the goal square. Good distance on the kick, but a 3-4, a minor score.
With Higgledon at the other end of the ground to do the kicking in. There's Talbot down the middle, Linger. Plays on, goes to the outer side. Should have torped it. No, it's not bad. Quinn Liven goes up, can't take the mark though. Needs some support. Muir to come across, doesn't keep his feet. And getting the handball is Toby Bray. 50 out, gives it a chug, has to have some support, gets around. Goes back towards Todoro, takes the mark. 60 out from goal, directly in front. Loads up, goes long towards the square. Shouldy stands there, takes the mark. Fantastic in defence, last line. Plays on quickly, gives the ball to Quinn Liven. Trotter short. Goes down the line though. Towards half back. Peel goes up. Takes the mark. Outside. Just outside defensive 50.
Starting to stop running.
Yeah. Chips the ball. Hybens takes the mark. A true half back. Ansell gives him a lead. Long on the wing. He goes there now. Sits it up for the big fella. Can't take the mark. Got a chop across the arm though, so Ansell will take the free kick on centre wing on the outer side. Most of the players between him and half forward, pretty congested. Hybens gets down there, he might go in that direction. Just loads it up, sets it up too for Carr, goes up and hangs off the back and takes the mark. She's pointed the wrong way there, the umpire, and she goes with a left foot kick. Towards our forward, McConaughey to Doro. McConaughey gets a push in the back. Oh. Yes. Yeah, that's all we like. Did you see that? We like a push in the back. And we'll take a free kick. Brett McConaughey gets centre half forward. A little bit of theatre in it. Might be too far out to score. He's backing himself, though.
Yeah, no, just outside his range.
Better on the run, I reckon.
Yeah, no, just outside his range. He might do the old Mark Jackson, mate.
Oh, no.
The mark.
Here we go. McConaughey comes in. 50 out, right foot kick, and off hands and through for one behind.
I know.
One.
Leach has played on. He's got full ground this time. Comes out, brings the ball towards centre wing, gets towards corner. He's picked the ball up, handballs back inside to Bray. Released him nicely, so Bray goes into the half forward line. Galley has a chance to win it, but over the top. Kitchen tried to tap it on. First to arrive, Hutchison went one way and now comes back on his left side. Kicks back outside and will find Bremner. In defensive 50, plays on quickly. That's what they've got to do. He finds Nelson in the centre square. He takes on Burke coming at him. Takes the bounce and runs away. Goes forward of their centre position. Kicks into the half forward line. Gets away from Lovell. Gerard Diswell picked up there by Carr. He's tackled. Needs to get the ball out. He did so. Went to Ansell. Stepped around. Run to 20. And John Ansell. He's missed it.
Bad miss.
Big opportunity there for Inverleigh and also to the Werribee side. The
stars aligned there.
Final quarter has gone now some 11 minutes. Smith Holden, Blood Suzuki scoreboard.
So Leach from fullback again. Wedderley gives him a lead. He goes towards Lovell. He's run out of the goal square. She's right onto it. So it'll be a ball up 10 metres out.
Future kids has always used the front line. Don't use the side.
So ball up. Hybens, Lovell comes back off a step. Garrard has touched off the boot, said the umpire. So through for one behind.
He's short, plays onto Hall. Hall quickly away and he kicks the ball outside 50, gets towards centre wing. Peel will definitely receive the ball. He's first to arrive. Has Smith in pursuit, but he swings back on his right foot, goes outside and will find Lockie Hill who presents up. So Hill has a player back in the middle of the ground. Hasn't looked that way yet. Was looking now. It's too late. So Lockie Hill needs to drive the ball inside. Goes to Hybens and he has the ball. So he's just forward of centre wing. Not too sure what he wants to do with it. Still plenty of time, so there's no rush. He comes inside to Nelson. He's been important with his link work so far in this quarter. He goes short and finds Muir. So Muir now goes quickly. This is a better kick. It's got a bit of height on it, so it's going to allow the defence for the Werribee side to get to the ball. And they need to win possession. Be the side. Can they get it out? Oh, there's a strong tackle in there. The umpire says it's mine. And she will come in and ball it up. I reckon it's only hard. A goal against them would probably break them, but they've worked very hard. They've got themselves in a position here. Lovell out of the contest, goes towards Bailey Buckler. He handles back to Dodaro. Good clean pickup, handled over the top. Trotter, good interception, takes a bounce. Needs someone to lead up for him. Goes to the left foot. Chance with Ansell. He's up.
Oh.
Mark didn't take it. Had players running past him. All the first two. Went outside to Carr. Carr from the pocket. Goes short. Finds Prendergast. Plays on. Runs to 10 metres out. Kicks around the corner. And Toby Prendergast has kicked the goal. His first of the afternoon. Now it's a close game. We have it.
Oh.
11 goals, 13.
Back to the middle. Lovell forward. Hardingham back in the middle up against Hybens. And Hybens gets it down, rove though by Teats to come at it, wrapped up, gets rid of it. To over the shoulder, geez.
Don't know about that.
So Teats to take the free kick, back into the centre square. Hall goes lateral. Called to play on. He kicks it to Leach, running back from half back. It'll sit for the coach and he can run free at centre wing. Ansell makes up a bit of ground, makes him come back inboard, keeps the pressure on. Great play, Ansell. Quicker than he looks, I reckon, the big fella. Teats, he put him under pressure as well, but Lovell can't have Hutchison on him. They need to make that switch. Lovell at centre-half forward. The big fella's got it. Got Bray standing by himself. Now coming out, Rosenwig. Bremner, Rosenwig, handball inboard. Cornish, quick reply. Little man misses. Three for one behind.
Ball to come long. That's where he's going to go. I don't think it's going to have the carry, but it doesn't matter because Nelson has taken the mark. Plays on quickly. Went back towards Muir. Muir now sees Trotter. Pointed to the centre square. Takes the mark. Handball goes outside to McHenry. They continue to run. Ball goes outside. Hyman's made up ground. Doesn't take the mark, but at ground level, the ball zapped along in front of himself. And I can't see who that
Ansell.
Play was. With Ansell. Couldn't bend over and pick the ball up.
Oh, there it is.
We've got it. We're sitting with the free kick. Goes to Inverleigh. So Inverleigh with the resulting free kick. At that point, John Ansell.
Oh, Teddy, don't want to
push over the grind. Ball goes into the half forward line. Carr comes out, takes the mark. And now he's right on 50. Again, this kick going back into the breeze, just outside his reach. Goes towards Prendergast. Doesn't take it. Devin Ellis picks it up. Tackle's brought down, so that's defensive work from Inverleigh. Great. Toby Prendergast lying over the ball. What's she going to do? She says it's going to be mine. Hybens just asking players to run. Taps the ball down. I think it was Hardingham who got hand on the ball. Towards the pocket it runs. Going back to the boundary line. Handball comes back in towards Hardingham. Can't get clean possession. Inverleigh still putting pressure on. Ball needs to be won at ground level. Picked up there. McGuinness. Handball went to Teats. Teats was put under pressure. Ball come out of the tackle. Hill had it. Put it down. Now on the forward line. Muir kicks back towards the forward pocket. Leach. No, it wasn't. It did. It was Weatherly. Had the ball. Lost it. Went to Hall on the right side. No, it wasn't. It was Smith. Now we're all getting confused. Brings the ball out towards centre wing. These are contest here. Three on two.
Trotter.
In the lead to win. Trotter. One way. Left back. Inside. Muir. No, it's not. It's Nelson. He's got the ball. He's been a great link through the middle of ground. Takes a bounce. Takes one on. Steps around the second. Goes to Peel. Inside 50. Love towards goal. David Peel. Oh, offline. One behind. 11.
Around the corner to Cornish at half back. Kicks it over the top towards Bray. Unattended. Takes the mark. Just holds the ball up at half back flank. Plays on Candy to Trotter. Plays on and kicks it outboard. Looking for Todoro. Close to the boundary line. Got two on him. Hutchison. They didn't talk to each other. And now Bremner comes back. He's got Nelson in support as well. Bremner kicks it across towards Muir at half back. Takes the mark. He can play on. Go further afield. He goes long with a kick. Over the head. Hybens and Hardingham to run onto it. Who's going to get there first? Hybens. He trips over at the crucial stage. He's still there though. Hardingham didn't come at him. He wheels around. Kicks with the right foot. Terrible off the boot. But it might be the right Peel. 45 out and closing. 45 degree angle. Comes back with a kick. Close to the goal. David Peel has put it through the middle and Inverleigh hit the front. His second of the afternoon.
They've just got all the run at the moment.
So ball back in the middle of the ground. Ruckman go at it. Tap down there by the big fella in Hyman's. Muir runs onto it. Eludes a tackle. Goes into the half forward line. Kick wasn't good. Doesn't matter. Carr's there. McConaughey runs onto it. Escapes the tackle. Oh, didn't have the ball.
Jeez.
Umpires allowed play to go on. Kick round the corner. Back to the goal square. Bounce over the top. Picked up. Higgledon round the corner. Goal! Inverleigh are up and running. 13-14 Inverleigh. They now lead or extend their lead 12-10-82 to the Werribee side. And it looks
Everyone's just stepping up now.
Need to stem the flow here, Werribee. Hardingham. Hybens gets it down again towards Mueller. Tapped it on Galley. Oh, look at Mueller. Look at him. He wraps. Oh, she loves it, doesn't she?
Oh,
over the shoulder again. Galley with the free kick. In the centre. Back into the centre square. He goes towards half forward. Calvert got three on him. Peel does well. Plays it nicely. Kicks it outboard towards Nelson. He takes the mark on centre wing. They just hold play up now in Valley. They know when to run and know when to hold the ball. And he just chips the ball beautifully. And Ansell, who has been huge too in this quarter especially, has led up very Ryan Kloster-like in the last quarter, his movement. He goes long towards centre-half forward. Carr got a sit. Goes up. Can't take the mark. Umpire says play on. He's hurt himself as well. Comes across half forward. He'll put the tackle on. Alice gets a clearing kick, but only as far as Muir. Muir 55 out. He's got a couple to lead too. It's Hickledon. Great kick. Great kick, Dean Muir. And he's found Zach Hickledon 30 metres out, 45, well, slight angle. You just counting to make sure. Zach Hickledon, three goals. This to make the margin 16 points.
I want to mark it down.
He's marked it down. Hickledon.
Right on the scoreboard.
Comes in, he's missed it. To the far side. Three for one behind. So three goals, 21 minutes played.
So now Smith has got the job at the fullback position. I suppose his only alternative now is to go straight down the middle because they need to score some goals. Smith now comes out, kicks towards the point of the square, going up. Mark
yes, got it. Oh, she loves
there.
It.
And the recipient of the free kick, Bremner. Bremner has the ball, puts Invalide deep back into attack. Mark required. Carr's there, over the top. Ball comes to the contest. McConaughey, he nearly had clean pickup. Went backwards, has Gerard, but he goes back as far as Carr. Carr goes back to Gerard from the boundary line. Loads up, kicks out of bounds to the ball. You can see as soon as he left the boot. He was over the boundary line.
He hated it, didn't he?
He did. He just wanted to swing with the boot. Kicks inside, finds Trotter. Not too sure why it wasn't paid. Now there's going to be a over the shoulder. So Clayton Trotter, being enormous. The centre work's been great. Goes outside. Hybens now slows things up. So the swing in this last quarter has been huge. Hybens now goes back inside. Has Trotter. Has a player wide on the ground. I think it's Bremner out there by himself. Can run. Can carry. Steps inside 50. Long kick. Goes towards goal. In the goal square. Car behind. Spoil. Ball goes through and is now pushed through for a minor score to the Invalide side.
Oh, here they go. The big
13-16 to the Invalide side. 12 goals, 10 to the Werribee side. To Werribee with some work to do. Don't do more. They're out there fighting. They need to get to the ball. Hall takes the ball. Has numbers around him. Went back inside. Free kick. Advantage has been paid. Now it's going to get called back. There wasn't any advantage because the umpire had stopped everything. And the recipient's going to come back now and go towards David Hall. So he has the ball now. Goes back inside. Has Brendan Chug. And runs through the middle of the ground. Loads up. Goes long towards centre-half forward. Numbers there with the Invalide side. The ball can't take it. Trotter able to get foot to ball, goes outside, finds Peel. Peel runs from the half back line, takes his first bounce, chips over the top, goes to Muir. And I'll tell you what, these guys have been good. Dean Muir has the ball, just taking a little bit of time now. Time ticking over towards 23 minutes. Invalide 13-16. Werribee 12 goals, 10.
Carr takes the mark, goes towards. Towards Garrard, and he takes the mark over the top of Galley, and he'll shoot the goal from 40 metres out, slight angle. Make it 18. Ryan Garrard comes in. He's kicked one goal, 40 out. Left foot kick. Galley stands the mark. Runs towards the boundary, kicks it right across the face. Hasn't got anything except the mark to Hickledon. He has. Is that Hickledon? I think it is. Yeah, and 50. Thank you. And Werribee have lost the plot. Zach Hickledon will come over and kick the goal in the middle of the goal square for his fourth and an 18-point lead to Invalide. So, took the mark and then copped a high one. And Hickledon would come in and kick into the school behind. Kicked his fourth. And the 14th for Invalide. They got a 14-16-100. They lead. Werribee Central's 12-10-82. And that is on the Smiths Holden Blood Suzuki final quarter scoreboard. We've been playing 25 minutes.
Yes.
Ball back in the middle of the ground. Not much time left now. Invalide with some time on their side. Ball's tapped forward. Wins up in the hands of Teach. Teach weaves his way through the contest. Kicks the ball into the half forward line. Going back. Hutchinson, no one wants the ball. Wasn't trapped by anybody. Coming the other way, Schultz didn't have the ball. Was lucky not to get a free kick. And now it's Montgomery. Kicks the ball along the ground. Finds Chug. Good tackle from Peel. Held up in the tackle. Umpire quickly in. And a short time by the Werribee side to pull themselves out of this one. But Inverleigh seemed to have all the momentum. Hybens taps the ball down. Clean pick up there. Goes towards Teats. Kicks the ball into the half forward line. It was full forward line. Lynn going back. He gets hands of the ball. Rosenweg gets the second one. Goes back. Goes to Knight. Steps around the first time. Muir comes in. Tackle. Oh, the first Woods. Time. She could have gone high over the Woods, but she's given the holding the ball decision. Dean Muir. I'd like to know what he's had in the last quarter, but it's been plenty. Goes out wide. Good kick. Finds Hutchison. So Hutchison plays on quickly. Goes further afield. Ryan Gerrard comes up. He takes the mark. And he's not wasting any further time. Goes towards centre wing. And Ansell comes up. Smith from behind. Mark's not taken. Smith fed the ball out the back door. Free kick. No, it wasn't there. Handball comes through. Goes towards Hall. Good pace on the left foot. Kicks in towards centre forward. Turts. Teats puts himself in the front of the contest.
No.
Oh, Chug was the late contact there from Gillett, but it was allowed to go on. Kitchen picks the ball up, went right, went back on the right, kicked towards goal, won't have the distance or the accuracy, and Lynn goes back, takes a mark over the line, and got behind to the Werribee side. Anthony Kitchen, 12-11 now to Inverleigh, 14-16. Game is over.
The ball was brought in, and it was marked by
Bailey Butler.
And he's kicked a goal.
So Bailey Buckler kicks a goal and finishes off Werribee at 13-11-89, but it doesn't matter. Inverleigh 14-16-100 have won by 11 points over Werribee Centrals in the first semi-final, and will meet East Geelong in the preliminary final next Saturday afternoon. And the winner there to play Bell Post Hill in the grand final in 11 days' time, so 13 days' time. So it's going to be a big week in Inverleigh after they've defeated...
Shane, at the start of the last quarter, you were just behind by a couple of goals and you're able to get back in at what is probably one of the biggest victories for the club.
Yeah, it was fantastic. The way they rallied and finished the game off was outstanding. I mean, we've had some wins throughout the year where our last quarters have been really good, but we've usually been up. We haven't had to come from behind like we did today in probably the biggest game of the year for us, and the way that they did, they rallied and they were outstanding right from the first bounce of the last quarter.
Is it hard? Do you think it'll be difficult for your team to get up 2 weeks in a row? It's probably a pretty dramatic win for them. You've obviously got a game that you can win. How do you go this week at training? Low key or high tempo?
Well, we'll probably just try and lighten up a little bit Tuesday, and we've only got a six-day break, so we'll just freshen them up. We won't do anything different. They'll still train normal drills, and we'll keep it. I suppose we'll just manage how they feel, the guys that are feeling all right. I mean, there was probably a lot of blokes that only played one quarter today, so not the whole group will be as sore as what they should be in a win like that. We, to be in the position, we obviously had some blokes that were passengers, and so they should be working nice and hard on Tuesday, and the guys that, had pretty solid games, they'll coast through and get ready for next week, so...
Do you really believe that you'll be able to beat East Geelong and then go away and go all the way and perhaps win the grand final?
Well, I guess you have to this time of year, I suppose. After a win like that, kicking into a breeze and backs against the wall and just to find something and actually dominate the quarter the way that we did was, there's a steeliness within this group that they're competitors and they want to win, they hate getting beat. So we'll be throwing everything we can at East next week and we'll see what we get. I mean, it's going to be tough. They're a good side.
Clayton Trotter and Dean Muir, two blokes that really, and I guess Zachy Hilden, all stood up in the last quarter. Fantastic.
Yeah, Dino was good all day, and Trotz sort of just got him back into it, and he's gone into the middle of the last 2 weeks, and we've sort of picked up a little bit, and Dean, his competitiveness is just unbelievable. He's got the heart of a lion, I suppose, and I think Peely out on the wing as well gave us a lot of run out there, and they really did lift, and Jimmy Hyvins finished off another. Great workman-like effort all day, I suppose. So, no, it was good.
Thanks very much, Shane.
No worries, mate.